going on, guys? So we are finally heading on our duck trip. Jamie there in the background. We just met up with Terry and Jim for the trip. So we are getting ready to head on down. We got a 4.5 hour drive, so it's gonna be a little bit of a haul, but about to head out. So here we go. Jim's ready to go. He's locked in. He's ready to go, locked in. Got the shooting glasses on already.
We're ready to rock and roll.
We got us a rental for the trip.
That might start.
Toyota Tacoma action. Ready to roll. Ready to roll. And stop and eat some Cracker Barrel, boy. Kicking the trip off right.
We're here in what, southwestern Kentucky?
Yep, we're almost at the Tennessee line, but we're getting ready to dip over into Missouri.
Get you a little geographical education here. We got some, we're up down here in the Jackson Purchase.
The Jackson Purchase. All right, well, let's go eat. All right, got full over at the Cracker Barrel. Getting fuelations in the truck.
I can't hide.
No. This Tacoma's actually pretty dang uncomfortable.
Shandyman's getting converted here.
No, not quite, but it is pretty comfortable.
Man, I really like this Toyota. Man, it gets up and goes.
I do like it. It gets up and goes, but I just don't think I would buy one. But anyway, so we're kind of all stopped off getting some gas right now, and then we're gonna get back on the road. We got about a little over 2 hours to go, and we'll be at the duck camp. So here we go. All right, back on the road again.
On the road again.
2 hours to go.
I just can't wait to get on the road again. Shooting duckies with my friends. Heading down to Missouri on the road again.
On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
Well, we are here. Pretty cool. All right, we're in the room. So apparently this used to be a small church and they've turned it into a cabin, so it's pretty cool. All right, guys, so got everything in the cabin and we're all about to go on the bed, so we gotta get up pretty early in the morning. We're supposed to be at the field at 5:15 in the morning, so we're all gonna get up about 4 o'clock and get ready to go. So we'll see you guys in the morning. Morning, guys. So everybody's getting up, getting ready. Old Jamie. But yeah, we got about 45 minutes before we're gonna head out there to the water. So getting jacked up, woke up, so here we go. Jim and Terry, they think they can hide in their sicker. I can see them all day. About ready to go. Yeah, boy. around. It's pretty cool. All this water and stuff out here. James, our guide with Devastation Hunts, backing in here with his side by side. It's getting closer and closer, y'all.
Jim woke up this morning. He never wakes up on time with no alarms.
Huh?
I got up at like 4. He was already sitting outside drinking coffee like that.
He's ready to rip, huh?
Wait till you see his other block.
Where do you want to be at, Chris?
Where I was last time.
Here's your chair.
I'm going to blame it on James.
Yeah.
Cool as crap.
Hey, did that dog stay in there?
Yeah, that's my dad. You lost him.
I lost him.
Yeah.
I see him looking at me.
He
right
found
now
a new daddy until his old daddy showed up.
Then he said, screw me. You know. You be on the left. I'll be over there on the right.
I'd give you a chance to kill the first one.
Yeah, I appreciate that. We should do that again.
Yeah,
I'll take your sympathy shots. First dozen shots.
It's level playing field now.
So if there's ever a discussion, we get a band, I'm going to get shot.
Oh, no. Not today, banded birds are mine. anyone that's killed within a 3-state area, I killed.
That's right.
There you go.
I killed it twice.
But I will confirm. On the last duck hunt, Terry did kill every banded bird.
Every banded bird.
Well, you can
every
have the bands. Bird I'll take the breasts.
Oh, you're a breast man. You're a breast man.
I got to eat.
But I can also...
Can't eat metal.
I can also claim that I killed every banded bird last trip.
Yeah.
That's right. So we had a mess of them.
Yeah.
Nice.
No banded bird got away.
That's right.
God, thank you for this day. Thank you for these men that are here, Lord. I just praise you for them, Lord, and I thank you that we can participate in this sport that we love so much and being outside and shooting these ducks. God, I pray that the ducks will show up to the party today. Help us shoot straight in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And help this dog to listen. Kennel. fellas.
I think about every one of us hit that sucker. That thing got messed up in a hurry.
Come in. Hold it. Hey, touch it up. Touch it up. Hold. Here. Touch it up.
Sick.
Nice shooting, fellas. That's the dead eyes that I like to hunt with. Kennel. Kennel. Out of way.
Yes, sir.
That goose did.
Oh, man.
There you go, right?
We had 40 in here. We'd be stacking loins, baby.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They'll be raining down.
Good old tenderloin.
Hey, James.
Taking a break for a few minutes. Step out here and stretch the legs a little bit. Got some breakfast warming up. It's gonna be all right. Oh yeah.
Sit.
Oh, okay, sit. Dad.
I don't want to sit. I just want to stand.
So, got the mojos moved around a little bit for adjusting for the wind and see if we can get some more in here.
Kill him.
Yes, sir.
Rumors spread around in that Texas town about the shack outside the game. And you know what I'm talking about. Just let me know. If you wanna go to that whole mile on the range, they got a lot of nice girls. I'm racing.
Was wrong. Pintail hen.
Cool.
Nice shot, whoever shot that.
Shoot, my guy, they all
would
have died.
Yeah.
Why didn't you?
There we go. Sweet. Sure.
All right. I'm going to grab that cooler so we can take one guy out.
yeah. I'm gonna get you when you go fall. I'm gonna have it on film. That second's gonna look real good with covered in mud.
Looks even better covered in mud, buddy.
Heck yeah. Yes, sir. Just don't follow me now. All right, guys, so that was the end of day one of hunting. Getting everything packed up in the Ranger and gonna head back to the cabin, chill out, get warmed up and eat some lunch. But it's pretty cool. Saw a lot of birds. We got four today. They weren't working quite right like James was hoping they would, but it's all good. We got a whole nother day tomorrow to try to get on them. So like I said, we're gonna go back to the cabin, hang out, get warmed up, and we're gonna get back after them tomorrow. We got the birds in the back of our truck. We're heading back to the cabin now to put dry clothes on, get cleaned up a little bit, and then we're gonna go grab a bite to eat. So, y'all stick with us. All right, so we're heading back to the cabin now. We got our bellies full at the old Mexican restaurant up here. So getting ready to head back there, chill out, shoot the bull, get some sleep if we don't wreck the truck first. It's we're running down a one lane gravel road right now with potholes everywhere.
Yeah,
but taking a shortcut, I guess. So anyways,
we're gonna end up in the marsh
probably, but anyways, yeah, we're heading back to the cabin, gonna chill out and get ready for tomorrow's hunt. So here we go.
Gonna follow this breastbone. Mm. What are you gonna do with a knife? So, you ever clean a turkey or anything?
No.
Pretty much any bird, they've got a tenderloin right in here.
Yep.
It's kind of like, they're like dove, right?
Yeah, just
so
like
I've done a lot of doves.
There's a tenderloin in here. Some people get them, some people don't. But I get down there and they've got kind of like a, it's like a rib cage almost. And yep. You ain't gonna have a sharp knife for birds. And you just kind of follow that rib cage out. Then you have another, it's not a bone, it's more like
cartilage.
Yeah, it runs right up through there. Cut down in it, follow it up. Sharper knife would help.
Yeah, I bet that's what was in the thing.
And I'm right-handed, so once I get this side, I always do the left side first.
Yep,
we'll get some, we'll wash them off. I spin them around, do the same thing. Follow it down. I get up in there because that tenderloin, you can kind of push it with your thumb. And this one's kind of shot up, so it's not as good. Like a good mallard that didn't get shot up too bad, you can really get that tenderloin. But I've got a little bitty SOG knife that I use. Mm-hmm. It's about that long, mm-hmm. And it's just deep enough to get down on the breast.
It's like perfect right to the handle.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
And then what'd you say up here? Just
watch that little cartilage.
Cartilage
is going to be, so I cut an angle about right there. And you're going to leave a little bit of meat on them, but you're going to get the most part of
majority
it.
Majority
of it. You can go in and they ain't got a lot of leg meat on snow geese or any of the ducks, but I mean, technically, if you wanted to, you can go in there and get that meat. We don't ever do it.
So here's that tenderloin right there, isn't it?
Yep. And that's a fine piece of jerky right there.
I guarantee it. All right, guys, so I'm about to head on to bed. Did pretty good today. It was a blast, but I'm super excited about tomorrow. We're gonna be hunting in the timber, so there's gonna be some cool footage and hopefully get on some mallards, so that'll be pretty sick. But anyways, this is part one of my dream hunt, so you guys stay tuned for part two, where we're gonna be down in the timber and try to get after some. So
Appreciate you guys watching, and we'll see you all in the next one.